Hello everyone, welcome to the fifth installation of Castle Story on Orosi Valley. We're doing invasion mode. When we last left off, we just defended what looks to have been the 16th wave, and you can see we've now added some more to our collection of stuck corruptrons. And we're gonna forever have waves 15 and 16 stuck in our collective experience. I think before the next wave, I'd like to try and get this outer door finished, so I need to get another layer and a half or so finished from this quarry, so I'll leave both of those guys on there. And I'd like to go ahead and clean up some of this as well. So whoever it is that's working on this quarry, I think it must be you, Zenar. Yes, I will have you come over here and begin our cleaning task, and then at some point that will extend into re-triggering our bear traps. Oh, there's the kitten. Got a little squeak to say hello. Isn't that right? Excellent. Some furry warmth for me on this fine day. Okay. I might go ahead and delete this. I don't really mind that it's not finished. The only obvious downside there is having the staircase still sitting there, but I can add that to this construction task, I think. If I just do one of these numbers. I should be in pretty good shape. Getting closer and closer to being finished with this construction, which is nice. The downside is that it's going to force me to start thinking about what we're going to do up on this portion. I think we'll do something probably pretty comparable to what we have here, with forcing them all the way up to the top and then down again. I guess we need to make them come all the way up here again if we're going to force them in this direction. I don't want to channel enemies through here, because this is kind of our central hub of where all of our access points are to the outer world, obviously other than the one that this will be. I guess that's a point. If we want to get people out here, they're going to have to kind of run all the way around this part, but that's not so bad. I suppose we could also do the jump-off mechanism. I could even think about building a staircase up the side of this, although I'm not sure. I guess at that point, if something were to break through this portion, then they could easily run up there as well, so that might not be the best idea. It'd be really cool if we could make a drawbridge with this, and have it, you know, extended over for now, but have some mechanism by which we could retracted or lifted up, so we would break that entrance point. That could make some really interesting stuff. Let's go ahead while we're here and retrap these bear traps. Boop, boop, so on and so forth. I think the mechanic with the bear traps is that they will actually slow and stop the smallest enemies, and for the medium and large, they will just hurt them on their way past. But they will always trigger the trap, and then you have to manually reset them, unfortunately. Strange that they... Oh, is that iron over there? It looks like the same. Strange that they didn't add it all to the same one. We have Mr. Kruda over here who really wants some bricks for this task. I know that the AI strongly prioritizes like a half full stockpile when returning items of that type, even at a long distance, which is rather unfortunate. How now is we're looking over here. Okay, we're on our last level. That's good. We could think about adding in the tunnel that we want to have, but we won't actually do it yet for reasons that are obvious up here. Am I doing the right thing there? Yeah, I think so. Let's see where this puts us out here. I suppose that's a little bit too low. Let's do the downstairs and see if that makes sense. I think that looks okay. Then we can add a staircase in there as well at the bottom level. And we have a couple of spaces for doors still. Should be okay. I'll throw some guys on that. I guess we'll finish with this by the time this wave is over. So let's see how that goes. And set this on all stockpiles to just be a little bit less picky, since we're filling up a little bit with iron here. I guess this will be the last clean that Xanar does for us over here, and I think I'll have him go and help finish that quarry for now. Construction is still happening, looking good. Well, kind of still happening. Again, weird that they're... I wonder if that's just the way the task's set up. Ooh, another archer. Perfect. Few more loads from these guys and those last 10 or so blocks will be taken care of. So effective. Kitten, don't lick me. That's, your tongue is so sharp. Yes, thank you very much. Very kind. Okay. Is that the end of that? It looks like it is. Let's go ahead and delete that. It should leave the staircase for us. Alright, Bobo, you wanna tunnel that as well? We'll get that nice and quickly finished up. Room for probably two doors there, maybe even three. Oh, we didn't acquire any more stuck individuals. We can actually go and get them, but it forces us to go out there and destroy the blocks they're stuck underneath. So it might be worth us doing that at some point. We'll send out a band of warriors to take care of that. I think the warriors can break the bricks themselves. Where are you going, you mad person? Your pack's full and you can't even grab anything. It would be really cool if I could send them out here and then have them like just dump the stuff off the edge. That would be pretty hilarious. Or somehow use the gravel as shrapnel for the catapult or something and not be forced to always use the explosive barrels. Another interesting thought. I must admit, I'm a little bit loath to use the catapult, purely for the reason of that lag that I mentioned in the previous segment, causing everything to blow up. They're quite effective if there's not lag. They do a fair amount of damage, and they kind of break little ground as well. But in the long run, if I lose a worker for it, that'll just be putting me so far behind. And frankly, we're doing so well with the strategy so far that I don't really want to jeopardize the success of this playthrough yet. Maybe I'll feel more adventurous later on. I don't know where you guys are going. But were you the one cleaning for me, I guess? No. What are you doing? Well, I guess they're going out here to mine the outside. Oh, that's fine. We've only got one more. Well, I better be really quick about this, then. I need to put some doors in ASAP. Let's get our x-ray vision. There's only two doors. I might... Wait, why is it so high up? Is that just what it's supposed to be? I guess so. I can add some stairs to that. Is that not the... Oh, here we go. I can add one more there. And have the stairs like that. And that'll be fine like that. I need to get that done quickly though. So next round starts in just over 3 minutes, and at the moment we have a glaring vulnerability. Which is very exciting, as you can imagine. I think what we'll do is add to this task just a few stairs on the side there. That'll be fine. Even two is okay. For a few more doors just to make our defense a bit more prepared. Okay, 2 minutes to get those doors put in, guys. You better do that as quickly as possible. Cutting it a little close here in this installation, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, there's some of it. Probably should have done the doors before I did the rest of it. Although here he comes with some planks. That's good. Finished like 3 or 4 minutes ago. I'm gonna send a third on that one as well, just to get it done. Is at least one door finished? Yes. Okay, that's fine then. Just a little bit of intrigue, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you're all okay with that. Nice. I'll actually go ahead and send you working on that now. Super good. What we're blessed with this next time. I'm actually going to go ahead and lock this outer door, even though it's not the outermost one. I just don't want my guys running through there and convincing someone else to do the same. Which means I probably need wherever my other workers have gone. Oh, get inside. Get inside. Oh, what are you doing? Oh my god. Don't need this stress in my life, you guys. Xanar, you absolute clown. Everyone, get inside. I'm not losing a worker today. Ooh, this is our first round with three large enemies. That's exciting. That was strange. Don't we all love bugs? How magical. We're safe to go ahead and unlock this and do that last door. I'll just send one of our fine individuals to go and do that, and the other, or another at least, to go and finish that portion. Once that section of wall is finished, I'll start adding some more barriers along the way. No more stuck units, it's also excellent. Bobo, I'd like you to clean up, please. In fact, I'll send both Xanar and you to go do that. More archers! Haha, we got poof this time, that's good. Oh, I better unlock that door so they can get in and out nice and easily. Sometimes it's easy to forget these things. Seems to be happily working. Aha, we have an outer door. How very exciting. In fact, let's keep that unlocked for now. Maybe our cleaning task will extend far enough down that they will choose to go out that way to get stuff and not have to run through this section. Okay, that construction is now finished. How excellent. One thing that could be nice, if we're going to have walls up here, is we want these archers to be able to get up there pretty easily too. So I think probably within the next episode or three, we're going to need to get rid of these trees and set up a walkway, kind of like what we have here along this side, but also along here, increasing in height to get to the relevant height for the walkway along this side. Just something to think about for now. It looks like with two guys on cleaning we're doing pretty reasonably as well, which is nice. Sometimes they get a little bit stuck. Oh, it looks like he's going to take advantage of our new entrance. That's very good. Effective. I'm quite pleased with this. I know I've said that once or twice, and I'm tooting my own horn a little bit, but also, I can't really take credit for all these ideas. I've just kind of put together the strategies that I've seen from various other videos and streamers and pictures from the Castle Story forums. So, again, not attempting to claim any credit for the strategy, but it's certainly panning out nicely for us in this playthrough. Bobo, what are you doing? You're on cleanup, huh? What do you mean there's nothing to do? Don't be a clown. Sure there is. Doesn't make any sense. Yes, that's better. Okay. I think with that, we're probably good for another few rounds, so I'm going to have these guys set back on the quarry. I'm going to have these guys set back on the quarry, looking at you, Xana. Having all the trouble in the world. I can move that nicely out of the way. For some reason, I kind of like not having them sit there, unless I'm using them. They're kind of just, the visual style gets in the way. It would be nice if they would go somewhat, you know, get some kind of transparency and have some opacity if they are not currently in use or something like that, but small quirks and foibles that I can mention. It's probably worth having a second work on this construction, so we can get that wrapped up sooner rather than later. It always throws me off, the three guys that we have stuck over there in our wall, when I move far enough away on the side of the screen, we get the notification that enemies are on the way, and I always, my heart skips a small little beat before I remember that these guys are so ineffective that they somehow got stuck inside a staircase, and they're having all the trouble in the world. Okay, nothing's really caused us any problems yet. Let's see what we get this time. Ooh, five big guys. This should be pretty brutal. I'm excited. Maybe our warriors will get a taste of violence. Doesn't seem like an effective strategy. Whoa, that makes me nervous. Look at those guys over there. Come on, Archers, get rid of those mediums so we can start focusing down these big dudes. Man, it's so beautiful. Should be actually no problem at all. Should make sure to have faith in this approach. This is really good. I have to maybe try something similar on other maps. If you, any of you have watched my first set of videos on, I forgot the name of the map now actually, that's rather unfortunate. I tried a couple of small strategies that didn't end up panning out, and I think ended up causing more lag. So, depending on the maps, something like this, where I'm channeling units through a particular choke point and giving them a hard time to climb over. I think this is the way to go, everyone. Easy peasy. Oh no, we've got another stuck one. Where has he gone? Is it all in the same place? Don't even see his health bar. I see these three still. Oh, there he is. What are you doing there, you clown? Here, that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna tease him out. I'm gonna find him. In fact, let's go ahead and clean up the other ones too. May as well. Well, we tried everything. That's fine. You just stay there. That's good. No worries. Whatever floats your boat. Levels dug out of this so far. Should be plenty of dirt left for us to keep building more castle-y stuff. Continuing our story, so to speak. Let's put them on our little causeway over here. That's kind of nice. What do you mean you can't reach any block to dig? Don't be a clown. I can't believe he's just stuck there. He's not even inside anything. He's just like, well, I guess he's kind of inside that wall. So incompetent. Guess we could clean up a little bit in the meantime. Seem to have a fair number of bricks. So such a task would not be too detrimental to our collection of resources. Obviously collecting them from cleaning up is much slower than collecting them from quarrying, which is right there next to the stockpiles. I did have this unlocked, right? Yes. I always get stuck trying to do that. I think it's probably worth keeping this section open, because what we might end up finding is that if we have archers up here and they're shooting guys along this, they might fall off into this section. So being able to climb out here and try again will be pretty important, so they don't dig through somewhere else. It might end up being more effective than I even imagined in the first place. Not much to say here, really. Things are going pretty reasonably. Again, I'm pretty sure we'll do something just like this on the north side here, well, the top side of this ramp. So probably not this segment, but whenever I return to this segment to do the next installation, I'll start mapping that out a little bit. Come on, guys. Play nice. Good. In fact, I could even spend a little bit of time really quickly doing that now, I guess. So if we know this is going to go up to there, say, I'll keep that one out for now. So let's say we have walls up through there. This would be where we have our ramparts. How large can we make this? Is that too wide? No, that actually probably is fine, to be honest. That's not bad at all. So we'll end up needing to somewhat destroy or allow passage past these stockpiles. Oh, what am I doing? I need to have them accessible there. I guess we'll have to wall off this portion somehow separately. We'll have that like that. I think that's going to be quite effective. So this needs to actually come all the way up here, doesn't it? Well, lines up quite nicely, in fact. sense of doing that. Maybe I'll even quarry that if I need to at some point later on. Okay, that's pretty good. And then I'll have, once I've built up this portion a little ways, let's call it, let's line it up with the crystal, how's that? So from the crystal, somewhere right around here, we'll end up with maybe our first method of getting past. So if you imagine, yeah, that should be perfect. We'd have plugs pretty much exactly what we had on the other side. Just large enough that it would work. Okay, here comes another wave. Let's get our warriors kind of set up in their defensive position. I think maybe in the next little while it might be worth getting some more warriors, but we'll plan for that a little bit later on. Ooh, here comes the lag, everyone. Okay, that's actually that construction finished. So let's go ahead and fill in the last of this. Ooh, that performance. And then judging by the time, it's about time for me to wrap this one up. So as soon as we've managed to defend this wave, it actually is pretty perfect because we will have finished the ramparts of this bottom section of the wall. So as soon as we come back in next time for the next section, I don't think I'll be making that today, so depending on when you're watching this, these videos should be uploaded as kind of a set of five, and then I'll come back and add a few more later on, assuming I can last for a few longer. I sincerely doubt that this wave will be the end of me, unless all the archers somehow stop firing again. It looks like some of them might be... Oh no! Fiddlesticks. Oh damn, that's unfortunate. Okay, it's just one, it's fine. That's fine, you guys can kill that one. Wow, that's unfortunate, I should really have closed that. Okay, we're fine for now. Wow, that was... if he'd managed to let the whole wave of those in, here I am like, no, we're fine, we're not gonna lose this wave. What are you doing? Oh my god. Oh my god. Get inside, you clown. That was not what I wanted in life. Let's get you all working there. Get to work. I can't believe that. I got so lucky. And so unlucky simultaneously. Sounds like the story of my life anyway. That's another story, perhaps. Oh, this is no problem. Our fortress is impenetrable. Our defenses are impregnable. It doesn't look like we're going to end up with any more stuck units either, so that's, you know, absolutely magical. Okay, that's going to be it for now then, I think. That's a very successful defense. We're at a nice point within the construction. So, as always, if you're having a magical time, if you're enjoying what I'm putting up, then you should give me a thumbs up. You should like this video, you should talk to me in the comments, tell me what you think of this strategy, tell me any suggestions you may have, any thoughts that arise from this kind of castle story experience. I appreciate your time, and I hope you all have a wonderful and magical evening.